Hey YouTube, today I'm going to show you guys how I made these off-white Vans Old Skools. The basic materials that I used to do this custom will be placed down below in the description. I will also leave a link to the off-white vinyl stencil that I will be using in the video. The first thing you have to do is remove the shoelaces from the Vans. Then I took a ruler and measured and marked a dot every 2 millimeters directly above the stripe. I placed the dots in a pattern that would form a zigzag. I did this to both above and below the stripe as a template to where I will be creating my holes to stitch through. The way I created my holes was by using a drill with an 11/16 drill bit. Of course, you don't need to use a drill to make these holes. You simply need something sharp and small enough to puncture the leather and create a hole big enough to pull a needle and a string through. So to create the zigzag stitch, I used a wax thread, so I needed to use a large needle to draw the thread through. Using wax thread is also helpful because you do not need to tie it to the needle since it is so stiff. Not tying the thread to the needle makes it much easier to pull the thread through the shoes. Now you want to start zigzag stitching the shoes with the needle and thread. You don't need any stitching experience. As you can tell, this is my first time stitching and I actually had no idea what I was doing. But later on in the video, I found a pattern that was very easy to follow and also looked good on the inside of the shoe, unlike that mess you saw on the inside of the first shoe. I also added an orange tag by folding up and gluing orange fabric to keep its shape, and also put holes through it so I can stitch it into the zigzag pattern. Here's where I found the pattern that was easy to follow and looked good on the inside of the shoe. So here, I'm starting from the top hole, putting the needle through from the inside going out. I also found it much easier to use some pliers to pull the needle through the shoe. Once you have your needle through the hole, you want to take your needle and stitch through the previous hole that already has a thread in it. Then you do the same thing, but go through the lower hole from the inside going out. And here's where you stitch from the previous hole at the top. Once you do that, you can just repeat those steps and it should create a zigzag pattern. You will know if you're doing it correctly if the zigzag actually shows and the stitching on the inside of the shoe looks neat. Once you complete stitching, you will have to prep the leather to paint on by stripping the paint using acetone and Q-tips. This will help the paint stay on the leather. Now this is where I used the vinyl stencil that I purchased from D-Nice Customs Etsy page. So first, you want to cut out the stencil that you will be using. Then you will have to remove the letters to form the stencil. After that is complete, you will need to take your transfer paper that is included with the stencil and put the sticky side on top of the stencil. It also helps to use anything with a flat edge to make the transfer paper stick to the stencil better. This is so you can transfer the stencil onto the vans. Transferring the stencil to the vans was a little difficult to stick on since the stripe gave it a bumpy surface. After you get the vinyl stencil on your shoes, you want to mix the black acrylic paint 1:1 with the GAC 900. Mixing these two will make painting on fabrics much easier and look much cleaner. The mistake I made here was that I painted too thick of a layer, so the paint bled through some crevices. You will need to paint much thinner layers of paint to make it have sharp and crisp edges. After using the stencil, just peel off the vinyl and make any touch-ups if you need to. And of course, I had to flex for the snap for a little bit. Repeat the same stencil process with the rest of the stencils and place the stencil wherever you want the design to be. Just remember to paint with thin layers at a time so that the paint does not bleed through any gaps. Here's the side of the shoe where I painted with thin layers and the words came out amazing. I also did some researching and found that Vans Old Skools were first made in 1977, so I put the number 77 on the back of the shoe as well. Here, I added a red tag that also came with the vinyl stencils. Then I wrote my YouTube username in quotes on the side of the tag. So, this basically sums up my video. Please like, comment, and subscribe for more. And here's some footage of the shoes on feet.